Hello, this is Jeanne from Jeanne's Endo blog. This is vlog number 2, following up to the first vlog, which was on February 16th. Today is February 23rd, 2009, and I just wanted to give everybody an update on what's been happening since the last blog post, which is a lot. First, I want to thank everybody for the feedback. I've gotten more comments back on this blog post that had the video in it than any other blog post that I've written since I started blogging in June, and I've got about 40 comments at this point, which is really great, so I really appreciate that, and that means the message is getting out there, which is good. And I've gotten emails and phone calls and Facebook messages and Twitter tweets with different feedback on the first video, and I'm trying to take all of the various feedback from the first video and try to use it for this next video. Couple of things I wanted to talk about. One is that one of the features on Twitter, for those of you who do have Twitter, which not all bloggers, but many bloggers do have, is a feature where you can use a hashtag and a code. And that way, every time you send out a tweet about a particular topic, in this case, endometriosis, you can just put that code on your tweet. So if you put the hash symbol and the endo right after it, at the end of any tweet that you send out, whether it's a message about the letter writing campaign, the petition, referring people to any of the blog posts on my blog or on any of the other blogs that are cross-linking with my blog. We've got a lot of stuff going on now, and we're trying to coordinate it so that the endo bloggers can all be working together towards the same goal, to try to get the attention of the media on endometriosis for factual stories. So any of you who are familiar with Twitter, basically just put this hash symbol plus endo at the end of your message. If you have any questions about that, just get back to me privately and I'll be happy to explain it to you. But I did try it tonight and it did work. I sent one back to the spoon lady and it worked perfectly. So that was good. I did do a blog post today regarding Donna Jackson Nakasawa. She, you may recall the name, was the author of the article in More magazine called Ill in a Day's Work. And I was very happy to find her. She actually has a blog, so I actually posted a comment to her blog today, and I sent out a request for others to do the same. I know that Endo Chick has already posted a comment there, and I've got several other messages out to people asking them to do the same. If you get a chance to go to Donna's blog and leave her a comment and thank her for the wonderful story that she did, and ask her if she would please consider writing a story about endometriosis, I think that it would be really a good chance to get her to consider writing it. She's obviously got a lot of knowledge about autoimmune illnesses. She herself has had chronic illness, which she had mentioned in the article. And if we could get her to write an article on endometriosis, we'd be very lucky. So the information for contacting her is on my blog, on today's blog post, February 23rd. And essentially, if you go to her blog, you just type a comment on her blog the same way you would type a comment on my blog. And if you don't know how to do either one of those things, let me know and I'll be happy to talk you through it. But essentially, at this point, we are gathering a lot more names on the petition. Family, friends, strangers, bloggers, endo patients, anybody who is behind the endo cause is signing up the petition and getting the word out to people, and that's really great. That's what we want. So we've got the petition going strong. We've got the letter writing campaign kicking in. We've got Endometriosis Awareness Month coming up next month in March, and several of us endo bloggers are working together to try to brainstorm and think of the best ways to go about taking advantage of the opportunities presented by Endometriosis Awareness Month in order to get attention for factual information about endometriosis as opposed to some of the media stories in the past that are not always fact-based. So that's just a quick update for tonight. Wanted to thank you very much for your feedback. Ask you to please continue to keep that feedback pouring in. Definitely please keep those letters pouring in. At this point in time, as much as I would love it if you would write to Mariella, as I had asked in the first vlog, I would really love it if you would comment directly on Donna's blog, because she's the health writer. And when I had communicated back and forth with Mariella, she had said that as a PR person, she can pass a message along to the health writers and the editorial staff, but it's not really her call to make on what gets covered in the magazines. So with Donna's blog, we have an opportunity to get right to somebody who might be able to have some sort of decision-making power in covering a story on endometriosis. And if this particular woman would take that on, I would be thrilled, because I know she would do a fantastic job at it. After reading her chronic illness article that she did for Moore in February of 2009. So I'd like to thank you for joining me tonight, and I will see you soon. Thank you.